So till now, till the last session, what all we have covered about the earthworm? We were started with the earthworm morphology and anatomical features about the earthworm. So tell me, what are the physiological processes we have studied? What are the anatomical processes we have studied till now, till the last session? Yeah, Vikram, tell me, Vikram, what all we have studied? Let it be, I will only tell. Okay, so we have started with the earthworm. Okay, that is anatomy and morphological features. First we have seen all the morphological features, which are nothing but the parts which are visible for us. Okay, with the naked eye, what are the parts we can able to visualize when we see the earthworm? Okay, that is nothing but the morphological features. And next we move towards the anatomical features. Anatomy is nothing but the internal part of the earthworm. Okay, in that we have started with the digestive system. Okay, we have completed the digestive system and what are the parts involved, how the digestion is taking place, everything we have studied in detail about the digestive. Next we have studied the circulation, sense organ, nervous system, and also about the respiration. Okay, since earthworm is not having any special feature or special organ for respiration, it will be respiring with the help of the general body surface, and that type of respiration we have called as cutaneous respiration. Okay, so we have come to the last part of the earthworm, that is reproduction in case of earthworm. So what do you mean by reproduction? What do you mean by reproduction? See, listen my question carefully. Okay, I am asking you, what do you mean by reproduction? What type of reproductive organ or the mechanism earthworm is having means it is a hermaphrodite. But what do you mean by reproduction? I am asking a general terminology, general definition about reproduction. So in the name itself only we can able to understand reproduction, producing again. What is producing again? Again there is a formation of organism, okay, or the progeny or the young ones. That common term we call it as reproduction. Okay, so when we define reproduction, it is nothing but a physiological process in which the organism is going to produce a young one. Okay, the organism is that is nothing but the parent is going to produce the young one or the offspring of its own kind. Okay, of its own kind. You cannot expect a earthworm is giving birth or formation of some other organism. Okay, we cannot visualize that a dog will give rise to a dog only, not pig. Okay, like this, reproduction is nothing but a physiological mechanism in which the organism or the parent is going to give or is going to produce the organism or the offspring or the young one of its own kind. Okay, it is the simple definition of reproduction. In simple term we can able to understand that reproduction is nothing but producing again. Okay, what is producing? Again, there will be production of the young one or the offspring, so that there will be continuity in the generation. Okay, so since reproduction is very important, so we will see what are the parts involved in the reproduction system in case of earthworm. So have you understood about reproduction, meaning of reproduction? If one take down the definition about reproduction, reproduction is nothing but the physiological phenomena. a physiological mechanism in which the organism that is nothing but the parent organism is going to produce the young ones. Okay, young ones. So to continue the generation. So have you understood about the general definition about reproduction? Reproduction is very vital process. It is happening in all the living organism. Okay, not only earthworm, in each and every living organism is having a mechanism called reproduction, and it is a defining property of a life. Okay, next. So tell me about earthworm. Okay, what type of animal earthworm is, whether it's a male or whether it's a female. Okay, earthworm is nothing but hermaphrodite. So what do you mean by hermaphrodite? Very good. Okay, hermaphrodites, it's very important. Hermaphrodites, I have repeated many times about hermaphrodite, monoecious, okay, then dioecious, everything I have clearly mentioned. Don't get confused about the terminology. So hermaphrodite is nothing but the organism, single organism like earthworm is having both male and female reproductive structures. Single organism is having both male and female reproductive structure in one particular organism, and that type of organism we call it as hermaphrodite. And the very good example of hermaphrodite is earthworm. Okay, when we see the internal part of the earthworm, there will be a production, there will be male reproductive organ and there will be female reproductive organ present in one particular organism. That is nothing but the male reproductive part, that is nothing but your testes, and the female reproductive part, that is nothing but the ovary. Okay, both the organs or both the parts are located at one particular organism, and that we call it as hermaphrodite. Okay, can anybody give me the example apart from earthworm for hermaphrodite? Can anybody tell me? Okay, then what you told Farhan? I will ask you later. Okay, yeah, can anybody tell me the example? Just search it. Okay, so you will find a plenty of organism. I have told you about the C. elegans. Okay, Mrtvittiri Anastheti, a very long back ago I have told you about C. elegans. That is also the example of hermaphrodite. Okay, I have told you a special characteristic feature about C. elegans in the very long back ago. Okay, when I was teaching about animal kingdom. Okay, let it be. Just remember. If you remember, well and good. If you don't remember, even more better. Okay, yeah, let it be. So we have seen that reproduction in earthworm, in that we are studying about the organism, that earthworm is a hermaphrodite. Okay, very important. It will be asked for your CET. Okay, just remember, single organism is having both male and female reproductive part. So tell me, what are the parts involved in male reproductive organ or the structure which is present in the earthworm? Okay, testes are the primary sex organ in any organism, okay, any male organism. And in case of earthworm, they are having a pair of testes, okay, they are having a pair of testes in the segment of very good, segment of 10 to 11. Okay, so testes are the primary sex organ which are mainly helpful for the production of sperm, and these pair of testes are located at the segment 11 and 12. Okay, and there is another important structure which is involved in case of male, that is pair of seminal vesicle. Okay, you are going to study entire detail about testes, seminal vesicle, secondary duct, okay, and secondary organs, everything you are going to study in the next year, that is in case of human reproduction. Okay, that is one of the important chapter, and very short, or the very short chapter in that you are going to study in detail about human reproduction. Okay, there you are going to study about male reproductive system and female reproductive system of humans. Okay, but when we study about the earthworm, because it's a small animal, it's a non-caudate, here the organs are not that much well developed. Okay, it is bit developed, but not to the more updated version, okay, more evolved version. These are having the pair of seminal vesicle, segment of ಎಷ್ಟು ಎಷ್ಟು ಒಂದ ಗೊತ್ತನ ಓಕೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಮೈನಲ್ ವೆಸಿಕಲ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಕಪ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅರ್ಥಮ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ pair of testes, okay, at that too in the segment of 10 and 11 there will be presence of seminal vesicle. Okay, it is also one of the part in case of reproductive male reproductive system, and that will be present 11 to 12. Okay, and there is a long elongated structure that we call it as vasa differentia. Okay, vasa differentia, very long structure, okay, and it is located at the segment of 10 to 18. Very good, 10 to 18 segment. Okay, because our earthworm is metamerically segmented, okay, so it is segmented, we need to just see where exactly the position of these parts. Okay, so for example, I will draw a rough diagram. Here there will be presence of two testes. Okay, consider this as a earthworm. Okay, two testes, and there will be presence of the seminal vesicle. Okay, this will be seminal vesicle, this will be 10 to 11 like this. Okay, the segments will be there, and along with this there will be presence of the vasa differentia, a long structure, long tube like structure, which is located from 10 to 18 segment. That is nothing but your vasa differentia, and these vasa differentia joins to the prostate ducts. Okay, these are going to join to the prostate duct, that is nothing but the last portion and from which there will be connection to the ventral genital pore. Okay, so after this there will be, this is a vasa differentia, is nothing but a long tube like connection. Okay, long or elongated structure. Okay, elongated tube like structure. And this is again going to connect to the prostate duct. Okay, it is going to connect to the last part of the prostate duct. After that it is going to be the ventral ventral portion, and from which there will be opening. Okay, a genital pore or the opening will be there. Okay, so these are the parts which are involved in case of male reproductive system. Okay, I will explain once again. In male reproductive system there will be presence of a testes, okay, pair of testes which is located at the 10th to 11th segment, and there will be pair of seminal vesicle. Okay, it will be a continuation. These seminal vesicle will be present at the segment 11 to 12. Okay, 11 to 12, and after that there is a elongated pipe like structure that is nothing but vasa differentia, and that vasa differentia will be present 10 to 18th segment. Okay, very elongated structure will be there, and next there will be prostate duct. Okay, there will be prostate duct which is located at the lower region or the after the vasa differentia, which is going to connect to the prostate duct, and after that it is going to form a ventral region. In that genital opening will be there. Okay, it is all about your, what we can say, the male reproductive structure. Here in the testis part there will be production of sperm, and there will be transformation during maturation or after maturation, during the copulation or the, what we can say, during the fertilization, that time the mature sperm is going to release, and at that time the testes sperm will be produced and it get mature, and through these parts it is going to reach to the there will be connection. We will study that. Okay, just first try to understand the part, and we will see how the fertilization process takes place in case of earthworm. Okay, it is one of the very interesting a topic. Okay, how the fertilization takes place in case of earthworm. Okay, so have you understood about this male reproductive part? Okay, any doubts? Okay, shall we move then? Next there will be female reproductive part. So tell me, what are the parts involved in case of female reproductive organ? Okay, in case of earthworm there will be ovaries. Okay, pair of ovaries. Where it is located? Twelve and 13 segment. Okay, so where the ovaries are located? So this is a earthworm, and there will be segments. Okay, consider this as a 12 and 13th segment. Okay, so these ovaries are located at the interseptal region. Okay, these ovaries are located at the interseptal region. Okay, so we can say that ovaries are located at the interseptal region of the earthworm, that is between 12 to 13. Intercepta means between these two, okay, between these two segments. Okay, that is nothing but interseptal region. Okay, and these ovaries only going to form the egg. Okay, these are going to form the egg in case of earthworm. pair of ovaries located at the interceptal region. Between 12 to 13. Shall I rub this one? Have you taken down this portion? There will be presence of a pair of ovaries, okay, which is located at the interceptal region of the earthworm, okay, and after that it is connected to a ovarian funnel, okay, it is connected to the ovarian funnel. It is again nothing but a tube like structure, okay. It is nothing but a tube like structure, like this V shaped structure will be there, and again it is going to end to the oviduct. The extension of this funnel will be oviduct, okay. So in case of female, there will be presence of ovary which is located at the interceptal region. Intercepta means the region between two septa, okay, that is between 12 to 13, and there will be presence of the ovarian funnel, and the extension of ovarian funnel further we call it as oviduct, okay. This is the organ which is involved in case of female reproductive part, and there will be another structure, okay. Can anybody tell me what do you mean by this? Just look at the NCRT diagram, okay, in your book, NCRT book. It will take a time, that's why I'm not showing, but during revision session I will show you all the diagrams, okay. So tell me, what do you mean by this? See, if you see your diagram, okay, if you see the NCRT diagram, see 4 to 6, I think there will be presence of these kind of structure. What are these? What are these? These are nothing but the spermatheca, okay. The structure which is present in the earthworm, the four pair structure, that we call it as spermatheca. So what do you mean by this? What is the function of this? Yeah, one pair in each septa from 4 to 6, I think, okay. And those, why it is useful? What is the function of these spermatheca? And the function of these is to store spermatozoa, okay. Temporarily it is going to store the spermatozoa, okay. Those four pair of structure, small tubular like structure will be present. In case of earthworm, they are mainly helpful, okay. Segment 4 to 8, these are mainly helpful for the storage of the sperm. Temporarily they are going to store the sperm, okay, that is nothing but your spermatheca, okay, at the initial stage only, initial segment only, you are going to get those four pairs of spermatheca, okay. These are mainly helpful for the storage of the sperm, okay. Spermatozoa is nothing but your mature sperm, okay, understood this much? Six to nine segment. Yeah, I am not remembering exactly. Just cross verify. Okay, just remember there will be presence of spermatheca which are present in 4 to 9 segment of the earthworm, and they are mainly helping for the temporary storage of the spermatozoa. Okay, understood this much? Shall we move to the fertilization process? How exactly the fertilization is going to take place? We have studied the male reproductive part, in which there will be presence of testes, there will be presence of seminal vesicle, and those are connected with the vasa deferentia, prostate gland, duct, and after that it is going to move towards the genital pore, ventral, that will be located at the ventral region. And in female there will be presence of ovaries, and the funnel shaped structure will be located, and that ovarian funnel will be located always beneath the ovary, okay. These ovarian funnel will be located always beneath the ovary, and the extension of the ovarian funnel we call it as oviduct, and after that it is going to connect to the genital pore, okay, it is going to connect to the genital pore, that part we call it as female reproductive organ. And there is a presence of 4 pairs of spermatheca will be present, and those will be present 6 to 9, and that is mainly helping for the temporary storage of the sperm, okay. So have you understood till now? Understood? Erad pen idra kodu top an irbagu. So shall we study about the fertilization process? Shall I rub this part? These terminologies bit difficult, okay, just practice them. Omme barangila, so practice madri you will remember, and practice the diagram. Even though for NEET the earthworm and frog is not that much important, but cockroach is important, okay, but these are important for your CET purpose, okay, and also for your board. So shall we study about the fertilization process? How the mating takes place, that we will study, okay. And listen carefully, okay, it's bit interesting. How the mating takes place, that we are going to study, and it is bit different, okay. Now we have seen the male reproductive part and the female reproductive part, in which male is going to produce the sperms, okay. When it attains the maturity, the sperm should be transferred to the other worm, okay. The very first work when attaining the maturity, after attaining the maturity, it is going to find the another worm or earthworm to transfer the sperm, okay. There will be transfer of sperms takes place, because it is a hermaphrodite, and in which there will be what we can say, maturation of sperm takes place first. After maturation it is going to transfer to the other earthworm, okay. Like this the process takes place, how we are going to study, okay. So the main region in case of earthworm is the clitellum, okay. The transformation takes place with the help of clitellum, okay. So consider these two as the earthworm, okay, these two as a earthworm. Now these two earthworms are matured, okay, and there will be production of mature sperms in both the earthworms, okay. There will be production of mature worms, I mean to say sperms, in these two earthworms, okay. After this, the first step, they will find each other, okay. To transfer the sperm, they are going to find each other, and with the help of juxtaposing, okay. What do you mean by juxtaposing? If this is a clitellar ridger, consider this the topan part, okay, this the top part of the pen, consider as a clitellum or the clitellar region. I have told you while teaching about the morphology, okay, what do you mean by clitellum? So can anybody tell me what do you mean by the clitellar region in case of earthworm? Or else just look at the diagram, okay, and have an idea about the clitellar region, where it is located. If you know that, this will be easy, okay. Otherwise, thali malindu hogibidu, okay. Have you seen the clitellar region in case of earthworm? Let it be, okay. So I'll continue. If it is a earthworm, this the top part of the pen will be your clitellar region. These are going to transfer the sperm by juxtaposing, okay. So I will tell you what do you mean by juxtaposing. Okay, these are the two earthworm. When they need to transfer the sperm, they are going to move like this. They are going to attach to this clitellar region, and this region, this pose of the earthworm, we call it as juxtaposing. Okay, this earthworm, the clitellar region, is going to attach with the another worms, the clitellar region, like this. Okay, this is nothing but the juxtaposing. After formation or after being like this, they are going to transfer the sperm, okay, between each other. This worm's sperms are transferred to this worm, okay, and this worm's sperms are transferred to this one, okay. They are going to interchange the mature sperm. Have you understood till here? Have you understood about juxtaposing, which is taking place in the clitellar region? Okay, just consider this as a earthworm. Heli la clitellum andra
nanna athilella
thililla. Okay, I will tell once again. Okay, so anybody is having doubt what do you mean by juxtaposing? Audible or no, students? Makkondira nallaru? See, listen, it's very interesting, okay. Just listen carefully. I have told you about the parts of earthworm in which there will be presence of dark glandular epithelial, okay, which will be called as clitellum, okay. See, if it is a earthworm, there will be presence of dark thick band which is present in the earthworm, that we call it as clitellum, okay. Now what we are studying means, exactly what we are studying means, we have studied the male reproductive part, yes or no? We have studied the female reproductive part. Now for a successful fertilization, for the formation of new organism, for the formation of new offspring, there should be fertilization, okay. Fertilization is nothing but mating of sperm or fusion of sperm and egg with each other, as a result of which there will be formation of zygote or the embryo, okay. So that how that process is taking place in case of earthworm, that we are studying, okay. So in here, in case of earthworm, mating occurs. It is a special mechanism, okay. in which the clitellar region, if it is a earthworm, okay, consider this as a earthworm 1, okay, and this as a earthworm 2, they will be present at different localities or different habitat. Now after getting maturity, they are going to come to each other, okay, they are going to come to each other, and there will be transformation of sperms, okay, there will be transformation of sperm, so that there will be fertilization. After fertilization, there will be formation of organism, because we have studied the very first part about reproduction. Here we are studying the how reproduction is taking place in case of earthworm. Now coming to the juxtaposing. Juxtaposing is nothing but a what we can say, a mechanism or a pose, we can say common terminology, okay, a pose in which the earthworm is going to transfer the sperm. Okay, this earthworm number 1, he has found the earthworm number 2, okay, now they are going to transfer the sperm, okay, they are going to transfer the sperm by means of juxtaposing. Okay, juxtaposing is nothing but these sperms, these organism earthworm came to nearby, and they are going to attach the clitellar region of each other, okay, this earthworm's clitellar region and this earthworm's clitellar region, they are going to come to each other, okay, so there will be connection, yes or no, there will be connection. Like this, the sperm of this earthworm is going to move inside the earthworm number 2. Illin sperm enaktiti idrolo bartid, they are going to connect. Yak ishtella madakattar ivra earthworm avu, yak ishtella madattara, to produce the egg. So can you think, can you able to think, earthworm is a hermaphrodite, idro male adava female adava, they have got all the gametes, it can fertilize in one organism only and it can reproduce, but yet it is going to transfer the sperm of this to this worm, and from this worm it is going to transfer the another worm. Why, what might be the reason? It is separate but present in one organism, that is hermaphrodite. Even though male part and female part is present in only one organism, they would have produced the sperm, they would have produced the egg, and they would have mated here only in one particular organism only, and they have produced the another earthworm. What that is called as? Genes different, very good Farhan. What that mechanism is called as? Yes, you have asked a question, no? Few days back you have asked the question, whether self-fertilization is good or cross-fertilization. This concept comes here, okay? So, to avoid the self-fertilization, okay? They would have fertilized here only. They need to avoid. If same genes are there, then there will be inbreeding depression. To avoid that, there will be two worms involved and the sperms are interchanged, okay, but egg remains same in that particular organism only, okay, that is going to happen in case of earthworm. To avoid the cross fertilization, to avoid the cross fertilization, there will be transformation of sperm. As a student, you should think that even though both organs are present in one particular organism, why they are transferring the sperm, okay? So in the earthworm, to avoid the self pollination, the sperms are matures first. That mechanism we call it as protoandry, okay? There is a mechanism to avoid the cross as well as self fertilization. So here the cross fertilization should take place so that there will be variation, genetic variation will be there, and genetic variation is going to help the organism to stay in this environment with a strong strong ability, okay. That's why cross fertilization should be must, okay. After the transformation of sperm, after the transformation of sperm, what happens is very interesting, okay. Consider this as a earthworm, this will be your clitellar region, okay, this will be another earthworm, This is nothing but the juxtaposing. Okay. Now it has transferred its sperm to this earthworm and it has transferred the sperm to the next. Now what happens? They just separate from each other. Okay. They are going to separate from each other. This is your clitellar region. Okay. After the receiving the sperm, there is the clitellum is going to secrete the mucus. Okay, they are going to secrete the mucus around the earthworm. The small portion will be there, and that is going to form the cocoon. Okay, that we call it as cocoon. The clitellum is going to secrete the mucus, that we call it as a cocoon, and it slides like this around the earthworm's body, and when it comes here, there will be egg. Okay, it gets that egg in the cocoon and it is going to come out. Okay, it is going to present in the soil region. The cocoon will be present in the soil region, and that cocoon is having mature sperm and plus egg. Mature sperm and the egg. Okay, so here in the cocoon itself there will be fertilization. Okay, in the cocoon itself there will be fertilization. After fertilization, the embryo is formed. As a result of fertilization, there will be formation of embryo, and that embryo, after 3 weeks, they are going to produce from one single cocoon 4 to 200 earthworm. Baby earthworms will be produced. Okay, from one cocoon there will be 2, 4, or again even 200. Okay, that varies according to the species. First, what happens? There will be juxtaposing after the maturation. They will come to each other. They just transfer the sperms at the clitellar region, and they are going to produce the clitellum is going to produce the mucus secretion. Okay, that is nothing but cocoon. It slides along the body of the earthworm. At that time, they are going to get the egg. Okay, the mature egg will be there, and with the help of sliding mechanism, they are going to have the mature sperm and mature egg in the cocoon itself. Okay, and that cocoon is formed by this clitellum, the clitellar region of the earthworm, and that will be present in the soil. Okay, after 3 weeks they are going to develop, and after 3 weeks they are going to produce the baby earthworm, and after that the baby earthworm comes out. Okay, because this development is direct in case of earthworm. Direct means there is no involvement of the larval stage. Okay, there will be no involvement of larval stage. Direct, there will be production of baby earthworms. Okay, have you understood this one? And earthworm, the last portion, earthworm is called as farmer's friend. Why? Because it burrows in the soil. Okay, it is going to burrow in the soil, and that soil is helpful for the root to penetrate inside the soil. Okay, like this they are going to increase the quality of the crop. Okay, they are going to increase the quality of crop, and there is a vermicomposting. Okay, there is a vermicomposting. The excreted product of the earthworm is beneficial for the farmer. Okay, because it is rich in organic content, which is helpful for the crop to grow better. Okay, this is all about your earthworm. Okay, have you understood about this? Any doubts? If no, okay, if it is interesting, no? It's interesting. Okay, just I will tell you once again, if there is any difficulty, next class I am going to clarify them. Okay, with this we have completed the earthworm, and next class we are moving towards the very favorite organism of yours, that is frog. Okay, frog ishta ala nimagella. We will see about frog, its anatomy, its morphology, everything we are going to study in the next class. So understood everything about this earthworm? Okay, we will continue in the